Alley Cam.
Good morning, JSerra.
Are we in? I'm Mr. T.
And I'm Sydney.
And welcome to the Mr. T Show.
No, this is Lion Report.
It's the Mr. T. I'm pretty sure it's the Mr. T Show.
When did you change this?
I mean, I think it's time to head into the announcements.
Good morning, Lions. Here are your daily announcements.
Sizing for the swimming and diving skier pack is today, after school, from 3 to 4 p.m. on the pool day. All students interested in joining the swimming and diving program need to attend. If you're unable to size today, please touch base with Coach Kevin in an email.
Come support your soccer boys tonight against Servite for their Lion game. The game starts at 5:30 and be sure to wear all white. It's also dinner and a game under the stars night with German food with a bratwurst dinner for $7. And then following the game, head over to the gym to cheer on our basketball boys, also playing Servite at 7 p.m. This game is also a whiteout.
Hey seniors, voting for the senior superlatives is due today. Be sure to check your email so you can vote.
And also seniors, this is your last chance to purchase your senior sweatshirt. Check your emails or see Miss O'Berry about picking yours up today.
That's it for today's announcements. Back to our hosts.
Thanks for those announcements, guys.
Mr. T, it's Friday. Guess what it's time for?
What?
The Pride Playbook.
Pride Playbook. Winter sports season is picking up and our Lions have been very busy.
Let's go check it out.
Hi Lions, welcome to this edition of the Pride Playbook. This week we have a player spotlight and some girls soccer highlights. First up, I caught up with basketball forward Jake Stafford. Let's check it out.
Hi, my name is Jake Stafford. I'm a senior on the basketball team and I play center. I started playing basketball when I was like a little kid, like 3 or 4 years old, and then I started playing like organized basketball when I was maybe like 6 years old. I would say my NBA role model is Dennis Rodman, just because of how hard he played and doing a bunch of little things to impact winning. That's really what I try to do. I have a lot of favorite memories in the JSerra basketball program, but recently we had some big wins in our tournament in Torrey Pines and in the Tarkanian Classic. We played some really talented teams and those were fun games to win. So next year I'm planning on attending UCLA to do track and field. I'll be throwing hammer and potentially discus. I think it's just such a fun game. It's like there's a lot of freedom in what you can do. There's a lot of things you can do with the ball or without the ball. And it's just a really fun, competitive game. I love it.
Thanks for that, Jake. Girls soccer is going strong this season and our very own Bella put together these highlights from their recent matchup against Modern Day. Take it away, Bella. My songs know what you did in the dark.
Thanks for that, Bella. Well, thanks for tuning in to this week's edition of the Pride Playbook. Let's all head out to cheer on our boys' soccer at 5:30 p.m. as they take on Servite. It's a whiteout and German dinner under the stars will be sold for $7. Then head over to the pavilion for boys' basketball as they also take on Servite. Thanks for watching. See you next time.
Thanks for that, Daniel.
Sid, did you hear about the winter play coming up?
I did, but I hear we have a segment produced by Elizabeth interviewing the creators of the winter play.
Roll it.
Hi, my name is Haley Kirchhoff. I am a senior and I am the writer and co-lyricist of Caught in the Thorns.
Hi, I'm Nathan Schroat. I'm a senior and I am the composer, co-lyricist, music director, and I play Hugo.
Hi, I'm Trinity Lee. I'm a junior and I'm the director of Caught in the Thorns.
Caught in the Thorns is the first student-written original musical at JSerra. Nathan and I started writing this show last year during our junior year, and it is a musical about a female composer in the French Regency era who is silenced by the world around her for being a female writer. On opening night, the director of their opera company is murdered and the company has to solve the crime. We had a lot of inspirations for writing this musical. When we were first talking about it, the vibes that we thought of was a mix of Little Women, Phantom of the Opera.
In terms of the music, the inspiration comes from all over the place, from things like we've already mentioned, other musicals like Sondheim. One of my favorite things about playing Hugo is the British accent, because it kind of is an opportunity to, like, I don't know, take it seriously, if that makes sense. He's a very layered character with a lot of backsides and, like, kind of darker things going on behind the scenes, so kind of integrating that into how I play the character has been amazing.
Whenever we were assigned this class in class to read through the musical, I immediately fell in love with it and realized there was a director position open, and so I applied, and I'm so glad I got the job.
My favorite part of the rehearsal process so far has been simply just watching all of the actors in theater bring the characters that I wrote to life. That's a really odd experience that I don't think a lot of people get to have in their life.
Seeing everybody grow and learning everything and it really come to life has been a really great process.
Yeah, I definitely agree with, like, the things that they've said, especially from the music point of view, having gone through the process of writing everything and kind of giving it to the actors and seeing them bring it to life.
My favorite character would either be Florence or Eloise, the two lead sisters. I love their dynamic. I love how they are such layered characters with a lot of different sides, a lot of different emotions.
My favorite character is Pierre.
Why didn't I say Pierre?
He's so blind. Okay.
He's like a take on the timeless trope of, like, unrequited love.
So my favorite characters, I guess my character, like, duos would have to be Florence and Pierre, because their duo is just so, so cute and so adorable. And honestly, I think Pierre really helps to create the character of Florence, because Florence has so many different facets. So I am also the choreographer, so I did choreograph the small dance section before the end of Act 1. So I am really, really excited for the audience to see that.
I think the thing I'm most excited for the audience to see is, funny, the end, the closing number, Goodbye Rose. Yeah.
I would agree with Nathan. Goodbye Rose, I feel like, is the perfect end to wrap up the show with a little bow.
Thank you guys for tuning in. Make sure you stop by the Black Box January 25th through the 28th to come see Caught in the Thorns.
Wow, that was actually a really cool set. I'm probably gonna go see that.
For sure. Next up, our boys soccer season is going very well.
It always does. I heard TJ produced a promo for tonight's game.
Let's see it.
Well, that's all we have for you on today's special edition of the Mr. T Show.
I'm Mr. Sydney.
T. Oops.
This has been the Lion Report. Happy Friday, Lions.
Stay classy, San Diego.